Pulse News on the Go, brought to you by
Galaxy A, your camera.
The Supreme Court has ordered the Electoral Commission to submit before it the full list of persons who registered with the National Health Insurance Scheme card as a form of identification in 6 days. This follows the former PNC youth organizer Abu Ramadan's decision to go back to court to seek clarity on the May 5, 2016 judgment regarding the removal of qualified persons on the voters' register. President John Mahama has once again clarified issues surrounding his decision to accept a 2010 Ford Expedition vehicle as a gift from a Burkinabe contractor, saying he even dislikes American cars. He said, quote, "I don't use Fords. I don't like American cars. I use Japanese cars. Toyota is my car. The issue of a Ford Expedition, I have never been under the illusion that that gift was a gift to the state and it has never been used for my personal comfort," unquote. Angry workers of the Electricity Company of Ghana have embarked on a nationwide demonstration over the planned concession move being considered by the government. Several of the workers, clad in red armbands, locked up their various offices to protest against the move. Addressing the media, the Eastern Regional Chairman of the Public Utility Workers Union and Senior Staff Association, Abraham Lincoln, said the workers will be forced to resign en masse if government fails to listen to their pleas. The Brongahafu Regional Police Command has indicated that it will not pursue the case where two young men were lynched in Brekum in the Brongahafu region. The two were lynched for stealing a television decoder under the guise of being thirsty. Speaking to pulse.com.gh, Public Relations Officer of the Brongahafu Regional Police Command, ASP Christopher Teria, said, quote, "Because it was a mob action, we were unable to arrest anyone," unquote.
Pulse News on the Go, brought to you by
Galaxy A, your camera.